In the northern part of Italy is the region known as Veneto, home to the cities of Venezia and Padua, an area that is steeped in historic tradition. In Venezia, or Venice, great art and architecture are everywhere, from St. Mark's Square to the festivals celebrated on the Grand Canal. The myriad shapes and colors are a kaleidoscopic adventure. A short way inland is the medieval city of Padua. The massive Basilica of St. Anthony stands over the center of the city. Also hearkening back to the 13th century is the University of Padua, where Galileo lectured from this very podium. The inside of Padua's Scrovegni Chapel is covered in frescoes painted by Giotto in 1305. The Palazzo della Ragione, or Town Hall, is a 13th century architectural marvel. It bustles with activity from morning until night. This area of Italy is also steeped in a centuries-old tradition of pipe organ building. The Basilica of San Petronio in Bologna is home to the oldest surviving pipe organ in Italy. Built some 20 years before Columbus first sailed to America, the entire 32-foot principal is in the facade, and the organ is still played for services every Sunday. Blossoming out of this ancient tradition is Fratelli Ruffatti, Ruffatti brothers, distinguished pipe organ builders of Padua, Italy. The Ruffatti factory has stood in the same place for more than half a century. Within its walls, old-world techniques are combined with state-of-the-art technology to create the finest pipe organs in the world.
We custom design Ruffatti pipe organs to the specific needs of each situation. A careful evaluation of the building, from architectural and acoustical standpoints, and sharing of information and opinions with our prospective customers, are the starting point for a comprehensive study of a new instrument. Selecting the best possible location of the various organ divisions, assigning the necessary space inside the organ for maintenance, and designing walkways to reach all pipes for tuning are essential issues to be considered, not to mention a rational wind distribution with an adequate number of reservoirs.
The aim of our visual studies is to achieve tasteful integration of the organ in the building. An organ design can be sober or striking, simple or elaborate, but it must give the impression that it belongs to the building. We like to give personality to each of our projects and to be creative, to provide decoration with grace and harmony of architectural lines. We want to put our clients in a position to fully evaluate our design, and to do so, we use the most updated computer technologies, with three-dimensional views and with renderings. These powerful tools enable us to place the image of the newly designed instrument right into an existing photograph or rendering of the space. And they let us better evaluate the volume of the new organ from various points of view.
In a world where every part can be bought from a different supplier, it is the Ruffatti tradition to manufacture every organ component possible in our own factory. To make pipes, we melt ingots of metal in a crucible, then pour the liquid into the casting trough, which slides down the casting bench to leave the wide, shimmering ribbon of molten metal that will cool into pipe material. The sheet of pipe material is planed to a uniform thickness, then cut to size by a high-precision metal cutting machine. Smaller pipes are still rolled by hand in the pipe shop, but larger pipes are rolled with the help of one of four machines specially adapted for Ruffatti for this purpose. The pipe metal has been painted with gum arabic, which will act as a non-stick surface and help guide the solder flow. Once the soldering is finished, the gum arabic is removed from the pipe metal and the resonators are re-rounded. As it has been for centuries, the material for the pipe feet is cut and shaped by hand around a mandrel. The edges are beaten with a piece of wood to bring them into alignment. The alignment is checked and adjusted until it is just right. Then the technician runs a thin bead of solder down the length of the pipe foot to join the two edges. This is high precision work. Even soldering must be done with great care, since the solder and pipe metal have nearly the same melting point. It takes years of apprentice training to become a master pipe maker. At Fratelli Ruffatti, we make our own reed blocks, starting with the pouring of the metal, which sets up in less than a minute. The blocks are removed from the molds, planed, and fitted to their respective pipe feet. Individual fitting rather than mass casting takes more time, but it makes for superior tuning stability. The reed blocks are milled with a special blade, then drilled to accommodate the shallots and reeds. We use a torque or screw type hand press, like those used in ancient times for printing, to shape this shallot from a flat piece of brass. It is further hand shaped, hammered, and crafted to be placed into its reed block along with a brass reed and tuning wire, such as in these huge assemblies for 32-foot contrabombard pipes. Ruffatti's signature trompette en chemade pipe resonators are of polished brass and look like real fanfare trumpets. The flared bells, which are shaped in our factory, are attached to the resonators with silver solder to make the joint strong and undetectable. Nothing crowns a facade like these horizontally mounted beauties. Rather than buying our wood from stock, we personally select the trees and oversee their measuring and cutting. These are logs of sipo mahogany from Africa, which is used in Ruffatti organs for everything from pipes to wind chests to walk boards. Each massive trunk is cut in two pieces lengthwise, then quarter sawn for the straightest grain. The cut boards are placed on spacers to ensure air exposure for all surfaces. They are then stored in the open, just outside the factory, to stabilize and season the wood fibers. The wood seasoning goes on for 5 years, the last part of which takes place inside the factory. Back in the wood shop, boards are cut for the wind chests and tow boards. It's easy to see the particularly straight grain of the wood as the boards come past the saw blade. The edges are milled to provide three triangular shaped tongues on one side and three matching grooves on the other to increase the glue surface and provide a more secure bond. The gluing process takes place in a special press. Its high-temperature surfaces rapidly extract the water from the glue, making the joint more stable. Our wooden pipes are made from the beautiful straight-grained sipo mahogany. The carefully calculated pipe mouths are worked, shaped, and smoothed by hand. When this process is finished, the entire pipe will be assembled. The different color inside the pipe shows that it has already been varnished for better resonance and stability, much like Antonio Stradivari did with his violins. Once the pipe is totally assembled, the outside will be varnished as well. Tongue and groove construction provides the utmost stability for every climate and condition. Wood carving is one of our many specialties at Fratelli Ruffatti. A design sketched on a piece of wood in pencil is transformed by our master craftsmen with knives, chisels, and sandpaper from a two-dimensional thought into a living three-dimensional sculpture. These majestic hand-carved griffins have supported the key desk to this massive six-manual console since 1966. The intricate detail of the hand carving on this console is of more recent vintage. It really comes to life when the stain and finish have been applied. We make all of the steel structure for our organs in the Ruffatti factory. This steel skeleton is set up and the rest of the organ is built around it to make sure everything fits and works correctly. Factory pre-assembly guarantees the utmost precision of fit and operation, cutting back on time spent with on-site installation and providing a better quality level for the entire mechanism. Any problems that may arise are worked out perfectly in the factory, where design and manufacturing support is available. Even our huge 4 and 5 manual instruments are entirely pre-installed at the factory. When they are again taken apart, each piece is carefully wrapped and labeled to make the rebuilding of the organ into its new home as easy and efficient as possible. We design all of our own pipe alloys. Our facade pipe mix can be as high as 95% tin. These pipes are hand-polished for an unparalleled visual presentation, then individually wrapped to protect the finish. Ruffatti makes all kinds of chests for both mechanical and electric action organs. This slider chest has flexible seals to allow free movement of the sliders without air leakage. Toe boards are of 3 pieces of solid mahogany, sandwiched together for stability. The pallets are designed for quiet operation. They are easily removable for maintenance. The rollers in Ruffatti mechanical action organs are made of solid aluminum, which greatly reduces torsion and guarantees a responsive touch at the keyboard. The connectors are made of wood for precise operation, and the linkages are easily clipped on and off for maintenance. Reliability and precision of touch are the ultimate goals. These are particularly important in an organ such as this one in Torino, where the console is 18 feet from the pipes. Ruffatti's superior mechanical action contains elements that reduce weight and inertia on the tracker runs, resulting in an easier and more responsive playing experience for the organist. Ruffatti also builds organs with electric action, using both electromagnetic and electropneumatic elements. Pneumatics are often used for the lower pipes, which require more wind velocity to speak promptly. By using the two systems together, we get the best sound and speech characteristics from each pipe. In all of our organs, we use fine, organically tanned Italian leather. Organic tanning retains the natural oils so that the leather stays flexible long after chemically tanned leather has cracked and crumbled to dust. The leather is glued and meticulously pressed into place around the edges and joints to make sure that the seals are strong and airtight. As an extra measure for leather longevity, our reservoir is designed to close completely over the leather when the organ is turned off, providing the ultimate protection. Ruffatti consoles are built for easy accessibility to all parts for maintenance. Keyboards are hinged to flip up for access to key contacts and adjustment screws. Side panels are removable to access the individual draw knobs and plug-in components in each stop jam. The console of the Ruffatti organ at the Crystal Cathedral is one of the largest draw knob consoles in the world. Regardless of the size, we build our consoles in many different styles, with or without our signature parquet platform. Whether electric or mechanical, our consoles and facades are designed not only to blend with, but to enhance the spaces in which they live.
Beautiful sounds from the ancient Venetian school of organ building form the foundation on which Ruffatti organs are created. However, a Ruffatti organ goes beyond. It's an instrument conceived for the needs of today and tomorrow. Versatility is the key word. It makes it possible to serve all the needs of the liturgy, to perform organ literature from different periods and styles, and to be inspirational for players and listeners. Once the choice of stops is defined, we then translate all of these needs into sounds by means of the proper pipe dimensioning. Even though pipe scaling is a very traditional field, research plays an important role at Ruffatti. Among our several research projects conducted in cooperation with international partners and the Fraunhofer Institute in Stuttgart, Germany, we have recently completed a two-year research project that has given us the proper parameters to adapt the pipe scaling or dimensioning to different acoustical environments. This is an aspect which is of primary consideration for the tonal success of the instrument. We use the open toe technique for the voicing of the classical stops, which is so effective in creating natural sounds and good articulation, and which also preserves the harmonic development so important for a successful blending of sounds or ensemble. At the same time, we use the closed toe technique for the romantic stops. Reed voicing is performed with a special eye on achieving tonal character while ensuring voicing and tuning stability. To reach all of these objectives, we encourage close cooperation throughout the entire process with the church musicians.
A good example of the value of Ruffatti's extensive involvement in research is found in these open contrabass pipes. They have an innovative, narrow shape that makes them extremely effective tonally with very prompt speech despite their size. Tradition melded with creativity, expertise, research, painstaking attention to detail, and master craftsmanship have made Fratelli Ruffatti one of the most sought-after builders of the King of Instruments all over the world.